Well, just no. Drop all the way. Turn up all the way. Up all the way.
Why? No.
I'm gonna turn it back down on here, dumbass. Turn up, please, please. Please, please turn up all the way. Please turn up all the way. Okay, now talk. Steven, talk.
But.
Okay, turn it back down. Turn it back down. Good. 70%. 70%.
Lucky
again. Never mind.
Butt cheeks, booty butts.
That's just it's actually called the clit right here.
Thank you for turning the monitor off.
Just like in real life, very bad at the clit. Anyway, that wasn't very imaginative. Usually I'm pretty suggestive, but that wasn't too suggestive.
They don't give you Michael Myers. What the fuck? No. They give you all the generic bullshit. They give you a Silent Hill bit.
Hey, Steven.
Yeah?
And what if they told Friday the 13th, hey, Friday the 13th, we'll take Jason Voorhees off your hand for $15,000. And they're like, wait, what's this game called? Dead by Daylight? Huh. This is Dead by Daylight? I made this. I made this. This is mine now. That's how I think Friday the 13th is created. It's like the exact same game, just like more added features.
No, but like Friday the 13th, Freddy is overpowered.
Yeah.
Really?
Not.
That's what I read. Heard.
You mean Jason Voorhees?
Yeah. No, wait. I thought you played as Freddy.
Huh?
Freddy Myers.
Oh my god. Freddy Myers. He's missing like three franchises right now. Halloween, Friday the 13th, and Nightmare on Elm Street. Players don't want to play there. If they want to, no real good players go there. Yet, even with that being said, they're still pretty good. Which is really impressive. They don't get good athletes.
They have to be.
Yeah. But, I mean, if they play schools in the top 50, like, the top 50 schools, they'll get destroyed. But if they play, like Fordham is probably top 250. So, maybe top 300 Fordham. So they can actually beat them. But it's still impressive. They probably get talent that's like top 500 talent. And they make themselves a top 100 team. That's what makes them kind of impressive on them. So they're like, they're in one... Oh my god, look at that beastly beast! God damn, they're good. So basically in football, you have three chances to get the ball to 10 yards, right? And that tells you right there. So you have first and 10 means you have your first chance to get the ball 10 yards.
What is this loading bullshit?
God damn, you're gonna learn football now. You can learn football now, right? Huh?
Damn, please, playing creepy Oscars.
Steven, do you know how to, do you know, if you watched a football game, would you know what was going on?
Yeah.
So how many downs do you have?
Four.
Which one do they punt on?
Zero?
I was trapped in my mother's basement.
Were you actually? That would be sense. That would be so cool if it gave you a background to the character. Why don't they do that?
I mean, you already know Michael Myers. This is probably...
I mean, they're not acting. Only Michael.
The nurse is from the college.
Is that what it said?
No, but it's an icon figure.
Sure?
Yeah. They always have the bobblehead, like, having it. I mean, of course, it's not, like, a complete, like, model.
Should be looking out to the distance. Is that him? Is he really up in that...
Hey! Shitty fuck!
He's no longer there, Tiffany. Are you kidding? You're just running back to where he was. Well, I know what he did. He waited for you to go inside, then he ran out, jumped off the balcony, possibly. That's what. Oh, that's what he was trying to do. That's why he was just waiting there. Why'd you?
Man, it took you guys a really long time to figure that out. There are no objectives. There are no generators.
There are generators.
I haven't seen a single one. I don't think a Silent Hill nurse would be able to carry this much weight. This is unrealistic. They should, like, have me still running away. That is completely unfair.
For the most part, not every.
Yeah. Stop what? Hold on a second. Okay, what'd you say?
I said Valve is chill. It's a chill company.
Yeah, they're pretty chill with their customer service.
Actually, I would say that's the one that works at.
Like, I would say that that's what chill means. They're, like, not doing much about it.
So bad, I know. I'm so glad I've never had an issue with Steam. Like, if I just get one issue, I know I'm fucked. Like, one day my, it says, like, oh, password has been changed. I'm like, oh, I'm fucked. That's it for me, this account for, like, 2 months.
I had an issue with them once, and I just, like, I contacted them, they contacted me back. The issue was resolved, but it was, like, something really simple.
Really?
Yeah.
He got his account removed, because what he was doing, his whole account, I think, like, he lost all his games.
Ouch.
I mean, he said he wasn't cheating, but I know he was. I mean, like,
what game was it?
Counter-Strike.
Yeah, he was.
I mean, he was clearly cheating. Like, he's like a pathological liar. So I knew he was lying when he said he wasn't cheating at all, but they caught me doing something on Counter-Strike.
Which is cheating.
Yeah.
I had to do fucking 30 on.
Yeah, exactly. No, but I was just kind of annoyed. I was like, why did you get used to it? You can ban him from that game.
I can, you know, you're...
The whole idea, early in the game, trying to go in the middle. Don't crouch. Crouching, okay. One thing I've learned, crouching gets you nowhere. Running doesn't really get you anywhere, but it gets you somewhere fast.
Like,
okay, fuck.
Wait, why are these skulls glowing? Why are they lit up? Wait, I can't put a freaking thing on top of you? There we go. Hey, can you run forward just like a foot or two?
I can't run.
Okay, not run, but could you like crawl forwards a foot? Well, that's BS.
What?
My mouse trap, my bear trap isn't working. Yay! I want Michael's money back, but I want to keep it for myself. And I can't freaking... Did I get called? Fuck you! Stupid game! And I can't even swing my sword at you. I can't! I'm swinging at you and it's not working!
What is this? This game's so buggy, it has to fucking hurt.
Fucking hell, I keep getting caught in my own bear trap. Oh, there we go. Entity is displeased. I summoned the fucker. Yeah, like that when you went up into the sky.
Your chance to blow.
This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, yo. That was fast. Did you somehow quit?
Where's my logic? you want to eat my chip? Fuck you! I'm pretty sure my computer performance is like 5 frames worse than the heat.
5 frames worse than what?
Because of the heat. Ouch. Is there really no mute button on this remote? The up-tempo offense against Dalen Dawkins pushes it down inside. How is there no mute button on this remote? What the fuck? That's so fucking weird. Dude. That's like just a common Steven, what do you think of that?
Can't you just like mute your computer?
No, I mean I'm listening to a TV show. Video game. Sports game. Steven, you okay? Yeah, I'm being bored.
I'm gonna pee.
You want a drink? Steven, isn't learned a word? I'm pretty sure, I'm not just certain it is, I've heard it many times by smart people. Steven? No, Pizza. Hear that right there? You hear that line?
Yeah.
Well, there's a meme now where like they have that panel. It's like, so you want a realistic down there show that's completely off the wall to the robots, right? And then there's a picture of Rick and Morty. That was pretty fun. That's so real. So remind me, okay. Oh, by the way, Steven, can you look? Steven, you there? Can you act with Steven and look up if Comcast is now supporting 4K? I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Is Comcast now supporting 4K? 4K on their Comcast boxes? Get it. They never, can I hear something crazy? Comcast never created a 1080p box, but they switched to a 4K box. There's no TV that runs in 1080p, but there are TVs. It's so weird.
Right?
No. Because I'm seeing, look at this. So now there's these channels, and like, I've never seen this channel before. It's 1303. And it doesn't do anything besides run it the same game. like, it's just running the same game, but it's in, like, it doesn't look that much any better. I'm just very confused what it is. I'm trying to figure out what channel all the games are on. Kinda like that, but it was different. I don't know what we were hunting. I think we both were just humming random things. We just happened to get on beat somehow. They get paid $15,000 a count. They don't get paid.
Whether or not
Oh yeah, it was constant debate. It's a very multifaceted issue because, I mean, there's maybe, it's on the simplest point, people are like, well, it should obviously pay them, but I agree in many respects, but then you also have to consider then all other college sports cannot be funded. College football, like usually if you have a big college football program, that funds all the other sports. So if they start paying the players, they would no longer be able to fund those other sports. So, you would have only sports that run out of pocket. Archery, you couldn't have any kind of sport that's not football or basketball might not run. Archery's fun, or volleyball, baseball for itself. Actually volleyball does do well. Volleyball does do well. Volleyball could maybe sustain itself. But those players wouldn't get paid.
Okay, fucking greatest sport.
Okay, oh my god. I think the only way they could do it is to pay or something. If, like, students would have to actually give money to the school for it.
Oh, can you give us another $10,000?
Yeah, and also scholarship. It was like, scholarships for those sports money. You no longer get scholarships. So, every guy in the soccer team is getting a scholarship. Yeah, you no longer getting that scholarship. So it's like, I don't know. I don't know how to feel. It's a very confusing issue. Holy fuck, you can't do that! Thank you! You can't do that, dude! So, the ball was... Yeah? The ball was punted off, right? When you punt off the ball's going way up in the air, and a player calls for it, and that means he's gonna catch it, and he's gonna basically stay right there. When he goes like that, that means I'm gonna catch it, and I'm gonna stay right there. That's only on punts, like when you kick a ball. So when you do that, you can't be hit, right? So he basically just cheap shotted him. It was so dirty. So he basically said, I'm going to catch it. No one can touch me. And the guy just ran after him. It almost never happened. He gets like basically yellow card. If he does something like that again, he gets kicked out of it. For this game and next game. So yeah, but you just can't do that. It's just so dirty because it's like so shocking. Because the guy's completely defenseless. There's a guy running full speed at him, and he just hits him. It's like the most dirtiest thing. Let me show you. One time. It's actually USC once did this. Troy Polamalu, very fast. It's so funny. This is my favorite. So this is one of the posts. But look at this. This one's my favorite. Look, some guy just made the title. Troy Polamalu is a thug and a shit human being. Because we'll watch the place. It's exactly what we're here, but it's a lot. USC lost this game. Pomalo? He's now in the Hall of Fame. Yeah. he's retired now. So there.
Damn.
He was calling for a fair catch. Which basically means you can't hit. And every player knows that. It never happens. Flagged, and that's the other team gets the football 15 yards forward. Yeah, there's 100 yards in the football, so that's pretty big. He goes running after the ball like he didn't do anything wrong. He's like chasing the ball like, oh, I can get it! It's so rude.
What about Aaron Lockett?
What about? Oh, Aaron Lockett, I don't even know. He's college player. Is he even doing that? Is he even playing the NFL? I mean, they're both retired now, for sure. This was like... Hopefully, he's like, they paralyzed since the Kansas... That would be funny. No, it wouldn't be funny, but no. Let's see. He played for the NFL for a couple of years, then he played in Canada. So, yeah, he made some money. He probably made $1 million, maybe. That's good. If he can... Yeah. Oh. Too much. There's nothing you have to know about football. He hit hard. No, a lot of players. So there's like 117 major college football teams,
yeah.
And there's only 30 major NFL teams.
Yeah.
And college football teams also carry more players. And if one college football team carries like double the amount of players as an NFL team. So as you can assume, most college football players do not make NFL, nor do they play very well. This guy. I don't know, that seems pretty evident. I think he did some times. I don't know. Like, I can just say, I don't know. Like, what he did was, he had, well, there's a few of them. But one of them was that he had his, he, like, had sex with a girl in the bathroom. And
Brett what?
Ben Roethlisberger. He had sex with a girl in the bathroom. But he had a security guard like wait at the door and no one could get in or out. At least that was what she said, and that was what other people were saying. They're saying they couldn't get in, they're being threatened when they tried getting into the bathroom. Let's see what happened with it. I don't really remember what the result was. Ben Roethlisberger, rape allegations. You're a quarterback is a racist. Every Pittsburgh Steelers fan has the same common rhetoric that's been applied to Ben Roethlisberger since a 2010 suspension tied him to a pair of sexual assault allegations. Both cases were dismissed. He just paid them off. Roethlisberger wasn't charged with anything. All parties involved seem to have moved on from the 2008 Nevada incident and a 2010 Georgia where an investigation ruled no charges in trial. Wow. Although he was suspended. With 5 years having passed and no legal ramifications playing in Roethlisberger, it would seem as the statute of limitations of hating two times before winning has expired. But you, oh, this is Steelers. Oh, so it's gonna be very, this is like a Steelers subreddit. So it's gonna be like, it's gonna be very pro Roethlisberger. He's on the Steelers. And he's a great quarterback, just a whole person. They couldn't prove a crime of the men. I don't know, I didn't think it's because he's had two incidents. I don't know, dude. He's had two incidents. That is a little concerning. I'm being ridiculous, but I don't know. I think there's something up with him.
In practice, and I just can't.
Wait a sec. You're so bad. What is it saying?
Really?
Easy pie.
SI?
Oh, really? Fuck him. Fuck him! Okay, I guess he didn't.
Guess he's back, guess he's back, guess he's back.
Tell me more! I want to know all the constellations!
Just kidding, sorry, I just had to do it, that was funny.
Wow.
Did that hurt, Steven?
I wouldn't say hurt, but that was really surprising.
Tell me more! I want to know-
Rutgers is beating Washington right now.
All the
Rutgers, the food place?
Well, there's Bud Jerry Rutgers, yeah. The cowboy. Oh, and that big dipper looking thing is Alan.
Not once.
The cowboy.
Not one time.
Oh, Papa Homer, you are so learned.
Learned, son. It's pronounced learned.
Time. I love you, Papa Homer.
I love you too, Pepsi.
Peppy.
Peppy.
Your mom really likes the cookie, but... That's the only thing I can see from that. Fast food is life. Fast food is love. Did you ever go to Burger King? Have you ever been to Burger King?
Yeah.
Why not Wendy's? Well, Wendy's is... It's like... Hey, Steven, wouldn't you say the quality of ingredients at Wendy's is better?
Yeah.
Then Burger... Steven!
Yes.
Then Burger King.
Yes.
I mean...
Would you say that there's no point to really almost ever going to Burger King if there's a Wendy's next door?
No, Burger King is cheaper and, like, they have more intense sauces.
Maybe not more intense sauces, but they have... I think they have a more varied menu.
Learned.
Jerry the cowboy? Cowboy.
Oh, Papa Homer, you are so learned.
Learned, son. It's pronounced learned.
I love you, Papa Homer.
I love you too, Pepsi.
Peppy.
Peppy.
Right?
Tiffany, can you tell when my mic is muted?
No.
Why are you asking Tiffany?
Because you've already answered.
This is how it's not all the time. You're on speaker right now, so probably not.
Purchase a brassiere. You kids wait over here in the credit department.
No, can't we just wander around and meet you back here later?
Okay, just be careful.
Would you kids like to come with me?
Sounds good to me. Let's go.
All right, thanks for participating in our focus group, kids. Today, we're going to show you some itchy and scratchy cartoons. We want you to tell us what you think, and be honest, because no one from the show is here spying on you.
Why is that mirror sneezing?
Look, it's just an old creaky mirror. You know, sometimes it sounds a little like it's sneezing or coughing or talking softly. Now, you each have a knob in front of you. When you like what you see, turn the knob to the right. When you don't like what you see, turn it left.
Washington's ranked 8th in the nation. Rutgers last year, like, won one football game.
Ouch.
So, what would you rather be rooting for? You're literally voting for Goliath times two. like Goliath, except Goliath also has like a giant training facility.
They like
to like work out all the time. And David has like...
seems to love the Speedo, man. What more do they want?
Okay, how many of you like Itchy and Scratchy to deal with real life problems like the ones you face every day? And who would like to see them do just the opposite, getting into far-out situations involving robots and magic powers? So, you want a realistic, down-to-earth show that's completely off the wall and swarming with magic robots?
And also, you should win things by watching.
You kids don't know what you want. That's why you're still kids, because you're stupid. Just tell me what's wrong with the freaking show!
Oh, Mommy!
Excuse me, sir. The thing is, there's not really anything wrong with the Itchy and Scratchy show. It's as good as ever. But after so many years, the characters just can't have the same impact they once had.
That's it.
Fuck,
that's
dude,
it,
that was
little
so close.
Girl. You saved Itchy and Scratchy!
Please sign these papers indicating that you did not save Itchy and Scratchy.
Rutgers, you know Massachusetts.
To the right.
Or
you
it's close to... Maybe Delaware? I don't know, actually.
They like Itchy, they like Scratchy.
Delaware, it could be New Jersey. Okay, I wasn't right. I was close in the same vicinity. This is a home game for Rutgers. That's weird. I mean, that's kind of weird when this small team is... Oh, that's... Oh, shit. Yep, that's holding. That's a 10-yard penalty. Against Washington. Yep.
BRB.
My mom's walking dog right now, so when she gets back, she's going to
the best part. Damn.
It's a kind of a hole in the wall place, so...
I love pinball.
Oh my god, it could be. The only person...
But you've never been there, it could be?
Okay. So David suggested it to me once, and I asked him, have you ever been there? He's like, not really. And but he did say, people like it. Like, people in Washington kind of like it. It's probably like Yusheng level. Of like, although I know that Yusheng isn't high. I love the one that not have time.
5 p.m. 9:30.
Dinner.
It's dinner. Are
we gonna
eat there? Or are we gonna
take home?
Right?
I know I'm being a fucking
fag.
It's so fucking hot.
No, but.
Yeah, I've done it before. I went here once. Oh, did I say I went here once? I went here once and I got like a suit, but I don't really think it was a good deal. I'm saying I went here.
It
was just weird. It was a lot of shit. We did a lot of shit. It's been paced by him.
Which is better,
but
I'm tired
of it. I can't indicate. I didn't think much of the suit, though.
Where's my pad tie? You don't have crab head tie.
I don't think you'd want to have crab head tie brought back to you in like 92 degree heat. I feel like a retro.
Yeah, I would take that.
Oh, nice punt. Oh, fuck, man. So Washington punts the ball, right? And once you punt the ball, that means you're playing. Even if you grab it, they still get the ball. So you punted the ball. People in their back, in their bathtub, in their tub, in their jacuzzi tub.
Why? Why?
They do that. There's a lot of things like that. They have like, they usually have pools in stadiums sometimes. There's one in Arizona, baseball team has one. There's like a pool that you can swim. That one's actually an actual pool. It's built into the stadium, so you have to look at that pool. It's actually pretty sick. One time when a team won, they jumped into the pool after the game. So that's pretty sick. But other than that, it's just like Baseball Stadium has tried to have a lot of cool things in it, so people who don't actually want to be there to watch the sporting event can actually be entertained. That's like the idea. In many senses, I mean, it's more like a party. They try to make the atmosphere more like a party. That's what stadium creators do. Or these business creators. Like, you know, it's like a business. You know? You're trying to make it more like a party, and you do that by creating a bunch of other events. So like the Ace game, there's like a kids set place. There's like a bar. You can go to the bar. You know that? There's a bar in the Ace game. And it's like a bar. It's
yeah,
when
yeah.
It's dark and it's like it's a room.
Yeah, I've seen it.
It's a fucking... In many ways, it's like, why? It's also overpriced. Of course it is. But, you know, overpriced. Now, what if they sell... They probably don't even sell liquor. That's a shit thing. I'm almost certain they won't sell liquor because they can't get you too drunk. It's like, because it's kind of, you know... They don't want you that drunk. Because you gotta leave soon.
Yeah.
You gotta leave in, like, a couple hours.
3 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't think... So what's the point of having a bar there? Maybe there's more selection of beers. Maybe. But actually, it's... Oh, actually, well, what I did was, when I got my beer, I actually went to a certain place. It's called the club section where they have a restaurant. Again, they have a fucking restaurant, but you actually are sitting next to the stadium. Some people buy shit cheap and then go to the restaurant and sit there all day and pay. In fact, for some reason, the waiters seem like they like you. You can really get a shit. They seem like they suggest, like, you can sit here for the rest of the game if you like. It's like, well, don't you want more people coming in so you can get more tips? Like, they probably don't give a shit. They probably just not. They probably just have, like, no customers. They just got, like, $10 other than work and get... You know, that's why they're probably working there, isn't it?
Yeah.
But still, that's...
Oh, we should go there next
time. The restaurant?
Yeah.
It's overpriced and it's crappy, but definitely... Actually, you know what? It might not be as bad because they did recently get a new... This is my problem. They did recently get a new food selection thing at the restaurant. Basically, we have a new owner, and his name's Dave Paul. He seems like a super nice guy. He has, like, office hours. I've never told you about that.
Yeah.
He has, like, office hours and everything. And he basically just listens to them. People are basically saying, the food is terrible. You have to fix the food. Get a new vendor. And he's like, yep, I'll do that. So, I mean, he's actually seems pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
Like, I think he's just really good at HR. He's just really good PR. He's just like a really good PR guy. And he just, but he also has like a 50% ownership team. So he has like a chair. And he has like a strong voice in the team. So he basically asked for better food. So now, I mean, I had a hot dog there. It was a lot better. I had a lot of fucking food there. Well, no, it wasn't that good. But, I mean, it was better. Okay, fine. We'll go there.
What restaurant do they have?
It's a shitty restaurant. It's a fucking, it's like a bar and grill restaurant, but it's a shitty bar and grill. Maybe they have short ribs. That'd be funny if they had a short ribs. What if they didn't? It's probably like $30, but I don't know. I'm not kidding. If they do have it, it's probably pretty good, like decently good, but it's like $30 if they do have it. If you show up at... Oh, I don't want to tell you that. Oh, okay. You could be able to get a seat not next to the one, which you don't really care about. Somewhat, but I mean, we could get kind of away from the seat, like, from the mirror, from the window, and we could get there, like, I don't know, like... Probably... Get their game time, like, you know, right as the game starts. Or maybe like 10 minutes before the game starts, maybe 20 minutes, I think. It also matters who they're playing. Again, remember?
Yeah, like
low demand. Low demand games, yeah.
It's against us
and
John's low demand.
High demand!
Fuck you, that's the low demand. The A's are playing.
That's a sound every day. That's like
right
the only
there.
A's game that definitely sells out. You know that? Because
it's two teams in the same area.
Yeah.
Plus, that's exactly
so. Fucking. Yeah. Yeah, the rise of right now, yeah. But in the 80s, the A's were popular. Right? The Giants had like, we would get like 8,000 to 9,000 a night. The A's would sell out. We would get like 35.
That's something.
But then the Giants got a new stadium and... I hate how only people like A's and are like, what about fans who just used to like the A's and still do? Because I know, so you know it's like there's like a growing hipster kind of hipster kind of...
It's not hipster, it's
trendy. God damn, I hate it so much. Meh, 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 meh But anyways, what do you want to get here? Patsy Ma? Green onions, come on, that's a light onion, dude. Dog. It's a light onion, dog. I totally disagree with you. Your mom is completely right, that's such bullshit.
Why don't you like the fucking SF Giants, man? That's
completely
bullshit.
Yeah, I gotta leave you to my door open. It's so fucking hot in here.
Lisa, we need to
leave
it in.
It didn't work. This didn't work. Well, I mean, that, I didn't mean it like that. Fuck. I don't know what to do. It's so hot outside. I'm actually getting really hot. This isn't good.
Wait, what soup did you
do? Well, I can't do it. I don't want to. Can I turn the volume for the game a little bit?
Yeah.
Sure. I'll turn it
down. I don't know why you turned it off.
Because that number 8 it's very distracting. You probably could ask. I was gonna get Pat. Oh, I was gonna get barbecue. I've had barbecue, I've had cinnamon, thinking that it could be better. I mean, that could be good, but I don't know. I find that I don't think the same. I don't like being... Huh? I don't like being good.
Yeah,
maybe
someday.
And it's kind of, it's got nice contrast. Where is it?
Crab asparagus soup, the fuck?
Where's the soup? We see what the soup
got. Pineapple prawns, fried rice. Pineapple chicken, fried rice. You just need more fried rice.
We can get that as well.
No,
wanna get that on the side?
Sure.
Hey, well, which one? Chicken or prawn?
I really love this Indian people.
You want it?
Some of it's so fucking weird. Like, one of the guys like, oh, you guys connected. Oh, hi, how are you?
How are you? I hope you are in good health and your family would talk to me and you and I know a lot of stuff with some of the most recent conversations and you can admire you so much. I promise I will be a sincere journey. I'm sincere to you. What is your name and how old are you? Married? What is your job?
And I have like the fucking marry me emoji.
So fucking
Why do you do this? Because I swear that I'm honestly want to talk with you. I have a boyfriend. Just one thing. I want to talk to you. Tell you everything. Just one desire for me in my life. What is this? Is this like real?
Yeah. What if you want, I guess maybe people like cats. Yeah, some people like fish. I don't really understand. Maybe on Omegle? I don't really get it. Many people are really like, there's just so many of them.
They were fighting over flight landing on India.
Who were? What are they saying? Can you read it out to me? I want to hear you. So it's funny.
Bro, hello flies. And what the fuck is up with him mixing all the shit on the ground next to his dirty ass? He's kicking dirty shit on me. Last night that he sat the fish and he sent the girl back to India. While he started the fire, y'all motherfuckers are nasty. Get a table, put on some fucking shoes. You motherfucker and fatherfucker, let your mom come clean my shit. I will fuck her ass, you bastard, lick my ass. You can taste spice in my shit. And give some of my shit to your motherfucking family shit eating members. Fuck you a lot, fucking parents. You didn't scare nobody, bitch. Suck you fucking father's dick. And your mom is a fucking fat ass cow, piece of shit. Go roast my fucking coffee, you bitch. You fucking dirty ass cunt, bitch. I'll fuck you hot up, okay? You can eat my shit, it's full of spices. I am your father, Shirokuchi Knock Knock Shinbon.
What's that?
It says, I am your father, it says all this racist Indian sound.
Well, Let
me fuck your mom and Aunt and Granny together. Okay, I love their pussy. Can I fuck through some with them? Can I fuck your mom and Granny in
the
ass?
This is one guy.
No, it's, they're fighting back and forth. I love the wet pussy of your aunt. I like your girlfriend's ass. I want to fuck her ass and get home. I let you eat my shit and get special shit full of spices.
But where the fuck keep saying
you?
That?
Where the fuck are you, shit eater? I'm waiting for you to clean my shit. Come and clean it quick. I just want your girlfriend's pussy and fuck her. It was full of hair. It looked like a werewolf pussy.
What?
Thank you for accepting my friend request.
I'll follow 4chan. It's pretty good. But it's not like 4chan. No, you just read things from 4chan.
Yeah. Like,
yeah. Or like, or like funny comic threads. Post the whole thread.
So, this is a small place, right?
It's almost small, yeah.
Have you been to it once?
I got a suit from the website. Which one? Let's see. Probably the hot and sour. I didn't think much of it. I won't ask David how good it is because he lives close to it. Because I don't want him to be like, oh yeah, you want to go kill me?
You don't want to?
I still want him. I don't want football. I'm
like,
I want
to keep out football. So who's your favorite? You don't have friends, do you? You have
USC.
USC,
they're my favorite. Yeah, I get, there's like 12 games here, so I get kind of pissed in the league. Not like yelling. Not like the Rice. Yeah, but they never won. They won it in 2004 when I was a kid.
So who won it last year?
Clemson. That's the school in...
They beat Alabama.
I don't give a shit. God damn it. Sending me news about Trump? Fuck you, Google. Fuck you, Windows. Do you really think you can do that to me?
Trigger.
I just don't need to hear about Trump fucking everywhere right now. So
he's always on
the news. I actually have a good job of not reading about him. I just read about him a little bit on my Reddit.
Why are you?
I want to see his ratings. His pool ratings have gone up recently.
37.3.
Yeah. Although Gallup gave him had a 34%.
Yeah.
And Gallup is one of the most popular.
But it
can
be biased right now.
It's more, this website considers it more left-wing, so it adjusts for that. It doesn't do this arbitrarily. You can just talk, Steven. Mom's at, fine, I'll just leave. No, you'll be fine. So, Gallup is more, it's considered more left-wing. I don't know how they do it. I think they check by who the average person is.
You know dog isn't an effective insult outside India, right? Shut the fuck up, dog.
That's funny as fuck.
Who's in RuneScape?
Huh?
It's in RuneScape, too.
What was?
Their argument.
Yes.
How many degrees do you have?
No anymore.
Really?
Probably around 95. I'd say 90. I'm guessing 95. What do you think? What's your guess?
I still think it's
100. You say 100. 100 something. Give me a direct. I give you a direct. You said 105. Okay. So whoever is closer buys numbers. I'm buying.
Okay.
What Greenbrae? Greenbrae? You're right. You're right. You got it. I'm paying. You're paying.
I was hoping I would be wrong, though.
I'm paying.
102?
Yeah, you You said
100. What is 7?
What did you say? No, I was 105. You said 105. So you're 3 off, and I was like 7 off.
So what's 7 off?
It's the same temperature. That's crazy. It's now hot right now. Yep.
I doubt it. San Francisco is always like...
San Francisco, I'm guessing 98.
Like, at least 94.
Oh, okay.
Oh. But still,
that's... What about, let's go again? So, Rodeo Beach. Although, I'm not sure how accurate this one is.
Rodeo Beach, yeah.
I don't know how accurate this one is. I'm gonna guess... Let's see. Oh, fuck!
That's way fucking...
That's not even that much colder than here.
No. That's way hotter than San Francisco.
What about... I wonder...
That's where the lyrical slope is.
Do you think they mean like just this? Maybe, do you think they mean like a part of Rodeo Beach is kind of far from the coast? But even then, it still gets all the overcast. It's getting really cold.
Like you start.
I don't know.
You start feeling like the cold one.
It says San Francisco. I don't know. It's on San Francisco. Are they using a different beach? But they say San Francisco. That's a pretty giant error. They're saying San Francisco, the county, which is. You see what they think Rodeo. Let me just Google it first. Let me make sure. Maybe they have it as like a... Nope, that's...
Part of the Golden Gate.
I guess so, it must be part of the...
It's so good though. It's right next to the fucking...
Yeah. Wait, dude, if a tsunami came, we'd be fucked.
Yeah, we would be.
Because
we're like...
No, we would, not like us. No, us, we'd be fine. We have a mountain. We have a mountain. But I'm saying if we were in Rodeo Beach.
Yeah.
Like what if it came, what if we got an alarm and what if we got an alarm? Yeah, what if we got an alarm and we got Rodeo Beach? What the fuck would happen, man? But yeah, but what if everyone's getting in the car and start fucking driving?
We're gonna fucking drive past them.
Oh yeah, I guess everyone's gonna drive past.
You're gonna hit the acceleration that I did and
Did you
see that iconic picture of the Great Depression and there's this car on this like really high road and there's like a dust storm like heading towards them and they're like driving away from it?
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, what's it called?
A Great Depression car dust storm.
What is it? So what does that storm still exist?
No, because we're better
now.
It was because of other techniques.
Really?
Because the thing is, we were not... We were basically using the soil way too much so that it basically was... Like, really, it wasn't like... hard enough, so it didn't stick to the ground, so once this happened, all of the fucking soil just came off the ground.
Really?
It really devastated the Southwest because there were more high.
Was this during the Great Depression, right?
Yeah.
This probably was one of the factors in it?
No, yeah, but it started because of the swamps. When this happened. Yeah, it was during the Great Plains.
This is a dust bowl.
Yeah,
I mean, I knew I should just have a dust bowl.
Well, we just had really shitty agriculture techniques. So after this happened, we basically had to... Yeah, it was on acre. So I wasn't acre to the whole time. So once we got, like, more than 400, it all just happened. Thing is, if you're caught in this and you would nail it, you're probably...
Good.
It's really
fucked up your lungs?
Yeah, because once you get that in your system, then it's literally disgusting.
So what would storms do? What would cities do? They just drive off? How long does it, how many times does it occur?
I don't know what it is. I just know that most of the damage is installed. really weird. Once the dust settled, you could see these gigantic
pools. Oh, really? Is that why it's called Dust Bowl?
Dust Bowl also refers to these things. But there was one picture of...
Cool.
Where it was just basically...
That's fine. I guess it isn't very much in school.
I think what my history...
We talked a little bit about this.
I'm so glad that we have better farming techniques by enforcement farmers.
Really? Yeah.
Well, like small farmers.
That's the farmers.
There's corporation farms.
Good. I like it. Damn. This whole picture of one. Picture. Yeah, that's what I see. That's what that gave me better results. Aftermath. So where are the bulls? Did that actually work?
Well, it prevented you from kind of, yes, because some particles could get in. Because you still have to facilitate air.
Why don't they just go into like a... Oh.
Oh, remember, this is also like, remember how the sun is going to be pumped over.
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Infrastructure in the south, and then the whole economy is collapsing. And plus, when the U.S. government told people that they would give you free land, you would settle the great plains. Just because of mining.
They got buried, though.
I don't know what it is.
Deep plowing is the dirt version topsoil of the Great Plains.
They just didn't know how
maybe it was a tornado.
I don't think tornadoes can do that.
Oh, yes.
Well, at least with tornadoes, they have, like, a fucking sound.
Oh, yeah. Do those work really effectively?
Depends on your house,
really. Oh, great.
Because you're underground.
With my foundation
yeah,
house.
Yeah, foundation house. If you have a shit house, probably. The north wasn't
flying,
but it was
about California. By the
Dust Bowl?
Why not?
Well, I mean...
We should have the windstorms, I guess.
Yeah, well, I mean, some of it blew over, but we didn't have, like, the windstorms.
Damn. Momentum is switched over to Rutgers, going to Washington. So we want me to call up an order?
Sure.
What was it called again? Timbuktu's?
That one is actually called.
Oh, it's not Timbuktu's. Pretty close.
That's actually pretty close.
Timbuktu's.
I don't trust Timbuktu's.
So what do you want to get?
I want to get some pad.
So, okay, we'll get pineapple chicken or pineapple?
Do they have just pineapple?
No. If you want to get pineapple chicken, that'll probably be less flavorful. Yeah, okay. It's less noticeable. Chicken.
Yeah.
And I'll get... And you just want pad thai mild?
Yeah.
And you're going to eat the green. You're going to eat the green. Green.
No. No.
I think it sucks. No. I think it sucks. When you drink that. It's like a trashy outfit. It's trashy that you can wear.
Yeah.
With the wife beater.
Not all the time. You can't generally wear grease like that. They call them a race. Fuck.
But people still buy them though.
If it's a different color, would it be considered a wife beater?
No. Maybe. A little bit. Yeah, I did a shape, yeah. Kind of. Cal State Fullerton, not good, I don't think so. Sacramento State is pretty low. SF State, I'm not sure they don't.
SF State?
Cal Berkeley has a football team.
I think SF State.
Not really. What? Not funny. Only one I can think of. Cal Berkeley is okay. Cal Berkeley used to be good. They're okay now. They're pretty good. They're like, top of the big school. Yeah, they're top of the big school. UCLA is good. USC. Stanford's really good.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it because they're just
recent? Only recent. They've always been okay. They're always good at all these sports. Stanford's good at like all these sports.
Is it because they're admission is because of sports?
Mm-hmm.
Like, are they like recruited
sports? Of course, yeah. They're not necessarily good. Although the academic department is usually a little bit hard, usually.
Like 7th grade or something?
What?
It's like a junior
something hard? Probably. It's probably, 6th or 7th. Yeah. 3rd or 9th grade. You're good enough. Yeah.
Oh, you need to write 715,000 pages. I said, don't worry, I'll just take it.
Yeah.
Talk about your feelings.
There's one guy, you became a janitor, and he's a Stanford dude.
Really? How?
He played college football. He didn't really have he didn't get a great degree yet. He didn't really have any skills. He like, read out of third grade level.
Oh. Third grade level, that's a... That's really fucking
important. You're going fine.
The thing is, like, football's not, like, a stable thing, you know? I mean, once you get out of,
Maybe it was fourth grade. Nothing bad.
Why do they read it?
Yeah.
Jason Reed. So we play football.
Well,
I mean, they can still speak if they spoke like... Do you like football? No. City sports. I heard bad things. Like the way the program was. It just seemed very... I don't know, like they had like a similar way you would... If you did something wrong. Like one time a kid, I remember the kid, he was caught reading playbooks in class, right? So they made him, like carry like his tires, like tied it to his belt, and they made him carry his tires so he vomited after practice. So they said that after he vomited. Apparently that's what a few players do, like multiple times. I'm like, why would I want to do that? Like, well, because you know, it's camaraderie. Working hard, that's how you get stronger. I'm not fucking hate you. Sorry, I don't know. Maybe it's because I just seem a little too much too crazy.
Too crazy?
Yeah, too macho.
Too macho for me.
I don't know. Kind of gorilla, like, I don't know.
You didn't play high
school. I played baseball.
Baseball sports, high school?
Baseball. High school. Question. One question.
A lot.
I don't know. It wasn't very good.
You weren't good?
No. I didn't get playing time much, but I don't know. I'm just gonna back. I'm not necessarily, yeah, I guess. Well, there was other factors. There was another good news. Here.
A lot of people who were like overweight.
Did you know who do football? We saw football team kind of sucks.
Really? Yeah. As far as like the worst.
Our coach quit, I think. But, yeah, it never seemed tough after that. I don't know why he quit.
Maybe he had a problem with the...
He was relieved as well as expected and all that. And one day he didn't show up.
Did you say goodbye?
I don't know. I never got the full story on it. Trying to get any part of your body. So
I'll cut open some skin and just put it on there. Any part of my body.
Oh gosh.
Did you hear about that person? She got her name like tattooed on her arm, saying like someone's bitch, and then she cut off the skin and sent it to him in the mail.
Really? Why?
He wanted to stick it to him.
Well, isn't she stupid then?
It was like really graphic too. Like, this is your tattoo. There's 720 people on the subreddit.
Which one?
The DN people Facebook.
Only like right now, as of right now. That's online. Yeah. They've almost subscribed.
Yeah, of course.
They
have like 180,000.
I'll cut my hair. She was looking high, no, with her feet right in her mouth.
I was late, your answer. I want friendship with you because I find an angel in the shape of you. You are like angel. You are honest, beauty, trustworthy. Sorry I hurt you, but take it. And then the fucking title was like,
is she
he's clearly in love with the shape of angels.
Is she a cute angel? Angel, get it? Is she a cute angel?
I
always want to know you can't talk to me. I'm shooting the shit. Hey,
shoot.
I ain't the gay?
The
gay? Are you the gay?
I should've, you know what? I should've discovered this year, dude. I went to and put it as my secret
club. Are you the gay? Part half, if you say. Mm-hmm.
Okay,
can I order out? Okay, can I get the pineapple chicken fried rice? And then could I get the pad thai with, the chicken pad thai mild with, can I get that with no green onions, please? Yeah, no green onions, please. Please. And then, could I also get the barbecue pork? Yeah. And, yeah, and that'll be all. Alright, thank you. God, she sounded like she didn't.
Really?
Like, Mike. Alright, Mike. 10 to 15 minutes. It's like the most weirdest kind of like vocal, like, I don't know.
Oh, he's the same person.
Huh?
He's the same person.
Like what? We have to go, 10 to 15 minutes is 12.5 minutes, so. Alright, so let's see.
Where exactly is
this? It's in Nevada. No. It's,
I was gonna say, I was like, damn.
No, it's oh. So we're like right there. We're right here. Right here.
Oh.
Well, we just gotta find the time so we can time it perfectly. It's not taking this route. I'm gonna see how I get in there. 8 minutes. So that means we have 4 minutes. It's leaving 4 minutes.
Yay!
How do we get in there?
Oh, did
Rutgers lose? It's halftime.
So much is halftime.
The halftime takes about like 20 minutes. Look how long deep it goes though. It was like that far, maybe.
Yeah.
So we're gonna park, so we're gonna drive all the way, and then when we leave, fuck, we have to go through here. That's fucky. Let's see how this game goes. We're gonna go here.
Oh, here's
this. This is the other game. They're showing highlights. This is during halftime, they show highlights. I don't know. I agree.
So what's the worst football
team? There's like, they get smaller and smaller. Teams get smaller and smaller and smaller. So this is Division 1. That's like big school, right? There's 117 of us. Then there's Division 2. Like, Army's actually Division 1. Then there's Division 2, which is like smaller schools, maybe like Sacramento State, maybe Sacramento State is a little smaller. Then there's Division 3.
So can a school like this have?
Yes, happens. But it's kind of somewhat not super, not super common. It's not rare, but it's not super common.
So how do they get to the...
They just keep playing really well, and they're enrollee either get bigger or their talent. They just start recruiting better talent. They basically, basically a new coach comes in. I mean, like, it's really hard to happen. They basically hire a bunch of new coaches over and over again. And they keep going, they keep making continuous success, so then players want to go there. And then those good players who go there, then that reaches... Then they reach a higher level of talent. Then because of that, they reach another higher level of talent. So basically, their coaching has to be continually better than the talent. That's the only way.
So who gets to decide whether like?
It's mostly just the parents. It's just basically how good they're selling out. If they're selling really well and their stadium is pretty big, then they can go up higher. Basically, if they can make the NCAA money...
Well, who do they appeal to, the NCAA?
If they can make the NCAA money, they'll move them up. And they move teams down.
Really?
Yeah. There was a team that won, like... They won their last game last year, and they got pushed up, so they went down. I forget they were. Idaho, I think? Idaho University. It's like one of the Idaho universities. There's like probably a bunch of Idaho universities. In Potato. Idaho University is Potato City. So. It's gone now. They all are fucking, they all do that. So fucking, I don't know.
Ask them.
Really? Yeah, I've heard that. Think. What time do we have? 40 seconds.
Where's the lighter?
He wasn't very good in the NFL, so now he's a sports guy.
and your phone can too. The 2017 Mitsubishi Outlander is standard third row seat, one of America's safest possible. Well equipped for under $24,000. Get up to $2,000 cash back or 0% APR for 72 months on select models. Joseph A. Bank celebrates Labor Day with up to 60% off almost everything. All travel and 1905 suits just $249. Dress shirts, full shirts, shorts, and more only $29. Plus, take an extra 50% off all clearance items only at Joseph A. Bank.
Sports watching time is the perfect time for my KFC $10 chicken share. All the balls are thrown, kick, and pop. Sit back with the rest of the prepared meal for you and a friend. Or a $5 bill if you don't have any friends. KFC, that's finger licking good.
Going to this school, they took out a very big student loan. It was the first time that I actually felt a sense of fear. It was stressful. Then my friend told me about SoFi. I lowered my interest rate by 40%, which will save me over $25,000. Now I go to SoFi's member events, and I met some really inspiring people. Refinancing my loan with SoFi was probably one of the smartest things I've ever done.
Save thousands by consolidating your student loans. Get your rate in less than 2 minutes. Visit trysofi.com.
Did you read DirecTV's latest deal? It's cheap and gets you all the big games.
It starts at $60 a month and jumps to over 100 after 3 months.
Cool. Think?
And jumps again to over 150 after a year. And ends up costing over $3,500 over 2 years.
You're cleaning that up. Don't get caught off guard by DirecTV. Get the best of the new spinning.
Downstairs to
thank you very much. So, Rutgers will have the ball at their own 35-yard line. And you get the feeling that the starting lineman originally joined what happened to throw the ball down the field. When we talked to Coach Killian today, he said he wanted everything to be short because the offensive line needs to get some confidence. But I think they've cut that after the first half. They had a little run of the ball. They had a little shotgun in the air. Wild Kyle makes it seem like a rush.
Sleep with the ball often imitated. sophisticated and pursuit-educated Dairy Queen Blizzard. There's absolutely nothing like it. Unless, there's two. Right now, buy your favorite Blizzard and get another for just 99 cents. That's buy one, get one for 99 cents.
I'm my debit card. Yeah, it's fine. Like, is it fine though? Just, I don't think I'm really worried. Do you want me to go back and report? I will. I mean, my bathroom's capacity. You need to call the bank. I don't know how to put it. You need to shut that car off. What? I can turn it on and off and I will fire back.
My sister was the wrestling manager for my first 2 years. And my mom, she's the doctor. If you're my opponent, I'm not just wrestling me, I'm wrestling all the Astros. So, good luck.
I'm not afraid of not letting me play football at 42. I've only been playing five in the Super Bowl caliber years. This is undisputed.
Heaven's One College Football is sponsored by Dr. Pepper, the one fans crave. Welcome back. Take 7 is Jim Browning, and the Huskies come back on the field. Browning had an interesting offseason. He studied Drew Brees and his precise passing and footwork this summer, and attended the Manning Passing Academy in Louisiana. Peyton Manning gave him some great advice. First down to 10 to 17. He said, you want to prepare, but there's definitely a line you don't want to cross in terms of over-preparing and thinking too much. Manning told him there's a lot of smart D coordinators out there, so don't try to outsmart them. Just operate with more precision. Such an interesting comment from Peyton Manning, who we always thought was the ultimate in just trying to outsmart everybody that he plays. That says, don't go chasing ghosts. You know, you try to eliminate the what-ifs. Well, what if they were there? What if they did this? What if they were on that coverage with this front? That's chasing a ghost. And that's what it means about over-preparing and trying to find something that's not there. The Rutgers defense bursts into David so far for Browning. And that's what it did to the loop. He threw that with into a crowd. Chip over Fletcher. The intended receiver, but Saquon Hackney, who's been playing lights out tonight, breaks it off. Well, we have not seen Washington convert on third down all night long, 0-for-5, in large part because it's been in situations like this, third and long. They have not been able to protect the ground in situations. I expect Jamie and Hunter's coordinator for Rutgers to send a blitz here at ground. Third and 10, 27. Brown. Personally, because there's a lot of contact that's going to go wrong, and I didn't necessarily feel like that was altering the play. Saquon headed to the injured Scarlet Knight on the field right now. We'll take a break as he gets stretched out. 10-7 Washington.
Where the heart beats warm and true. That's Texas. Where we always welcome. That's Texas. Where we always find a way. That's Texas.
Thank you.
Yeah.
and cut rewards for Pizza Hut. Finally, a reward program that gives you points for free pizza with every dollar you spend online. And get unlimited dollar rewards through October 1st.
How about if I give you $5? Then we can come up here and finish the
pizza. Yes.
And,
make
some popcorn.
Start your Sunday with Chris Tufts, Tony Gonzalez, Dave Monster, Carl Cow, and Michael Bay, covering all the NFL news.
Oh, it's a good show.
It all begins September 10th with Fox NFL Kickoff. State last night, pull away in the second half. JT Barrett, 4 total TDs, racked up almost 600 yards of offense. Can't wait to see Lamar Jackson is on board. That Heisman Trophy winning season is going to have to put to bed and the struggles at the end of last season. I'm sure he can do that tomorrow night. I tell you what though, Joel, I'm excited to watch Tom Herman's Texas Longhorns. I am too. I think they could be a real surprise team in the Big 12. Maybe even threatening for that conference championship. Got a lot of talent that Charlie Strong recruited there, and I think Tom Herman is a here's Raheem Blackshear, the freshman. He's a perfect style of motivator and also a guy that they desperately needed in Austin. You know, things have gotten really stale in Austin from the administration on down. And they needed someone to come in there and blow it. And that's exactly what Tom Herman has done. I mean, he went in and locker room slipped, busted into the wall, so very excited for what Herman could mean for the University of Texas and the Big 12 conference as a whole. Second and 7 at the 27. Robert Martin the game now, running back for Rutgers. Martin. And now to the 30. Insert play call. Ida Scarlett, though, it says Miles Bryant makes his tackles without bringing. Third down and 4 for Coach Ash's offense. Very conservative. And listen, they implored this game plan. They were going to be conservative. They wanted to shorten the game. They have done that thus far. They have limited the number of opportunities and number of snaps that Washington was going to be afforded. But at some point, they're going to have to make a play, in particular in a situation like this on third down. He's fast, strong guy, 6'4", 250, and a compact runner because him racing across the field, that ball has to be on the ball. You know, if it's behind him at all, that's a big provision. That's just one part of it. You don't get the first down because he stumbles. It's in right in his hands, so he can run through the ball and get that first down. Excellent. His problem. There was a wide receiver outside of him that lined up on the line of scrimmage, and so when he went down the field, the penalty's on him. But actually, it was number 5, Damon Mitchell, who was misaligned, and that's the type of mistake that Chris Ash was talking to us before the game about. That's the thing, that the not beating yourself element of what we want to receive from this team tonight, which, by the way, they've achieved a lot of their objectives, playing hard, playing with all the time. Not necessarily self-inflicted wound, I guess is what you're saying.
That's right.
He had a great comment, and a lot of coaches around the country will tell you this, have this sentiment, that games, for the most part, are generally lost and not won. And what he wants to do is make sure that Rutgers is a team that doesn't go out there and actively lose the football game. And once he can turn that corner, then he can start talking about making the plays to win it. Second and second. Bowen checks it off. Looks like an offside. Huskies, as they get the ball up to the 41, Blanchard again. This time in the passing game. Number 8, Washington. Too quick of a stop here. His outside linebacker's caught just across that neutral zone when the ball is snapped. So now, here's the situation. Now, if you are going to get aggressive, this is a spot to do it. Because when you've got second and short, that you can always come back and hand the ball off and third and short and still move the chains. So if Jared Kill wants to try to hit the shot, stay tight in this game. This is a great spot to do that. Second and 2. So it remains third down at 2. Will be at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena for an SEC versus Pac-12 showdown as the Texas A&M Aggies roll into town to take on Josh Rosen. And the UCLA Bruins covers begin at 7 p.m. Eastern. That game on Fox.
Oh, that is such a good game. Both of those programs, both of those head coaches really need a win. And Jim Mora has the benefit of having one of the most talented players in the country.
UCLA Bruins. Tim Poirier, 300-yard passing game. When you talk of NFL scouts, this guy has immense talent. Probably be selected in the top three picks in the next spring football draft. First down, 10-15, run over the middle. Back to with the draft. Draft the turn for Jets again. 15-yard gain. DeAndre Roberts with the tackle. If someone's just at home and maybe flipping between channels and they see Washington takes the lead and they think to themselves, hey, this might just be a Ohio State, Indiana type of thing. I don't think that it's been that way. There's been a few mistakes from Rutgers that has allowed Washington to hold this lead. Washington has not driven the ball, but Mike will field all night long. Let's see if they can do it here. He's drawing it up the sideline. Close enough for them to take a look. We have our first review of the game. What concentration just for this to be even a review? This will give us an opportunity to go to our anatomy attire and some movies. That's right, we got two now. The Blandino. Really taking a lot of shine from Mike Herrera. Guys, can you hear us? What are you doing?
We can. We looked at that play right off the bat. Indeed, we both agree with the call, a great call on the field, because really he doesn't get control until he brings the ball in.
Yeah, I think that's the key. When he brings the ball into his chest, it looks like that right foot is hitting the end line, and that would make it incomplete. What do you think about the contact earlier in the play? I agree with you. I think this is going to stand. There's not enough to overturn this clearly.
We're going to throw the two and make the three pass. Third down.
And they will confirm it there. That contact earlier, the LaSalle Austin kind of holding that right arm of Pettis. I thought it could have drawn a play.
Yeah, you know, you always get suspicious, Joel, when you see the one hand making the catch. And that's what caused me to take a look at that. And it did look like he had it pinned down a little bit. From getting that arm up.
All right, guys, thank you very much. We're down and going with a five for Washington. receiver, and Michelli broke open late, but that ball thrown just a tad high. Now, Browning has just been off all night long, whether it's been the pressure being applied by Rutgers or the fact that he's choosing the wrong throw at times. Thus, when you're inside the 10, that ball has got to be driven onto the frame of the wide receiver. You can't lob the ball inside the 10, in particular on the crossing route. Browning has got to know better than that and execute better when he's inside the 10. His day will have to take the 23-yard field goal. Well, the Huskies will take the 3 points, and with 2:45 to go, the third in Washington up 20-7.
Houston's remains stays tough for a lifetime. For $250, you'll be one happy camper. Cabela's Polo Captain Classic Cool. Great price, lifetime guarantee.
So should you. A stop, breakers, socks.
Does he turn everything to gold?
Not everything.
At Midas, we're always a touch better. Looking up by minute, Midas.com.
Jake Browning and the Washington Huskies take the 27 lead, but it's been anything but easy for Browning. We had a sensational first 9 games a year ago, but tonight, you know, decision making at the quarterback position is not just where you're throwing the football, but how you're throwing the football. There's driving the football on the frame, the wide receiver was. There's throwing the ball deep with touch, and there's also that layered ball kind of in front of the safeties or the linebackers. I feel like his decision making in terms of the way he's throwing it has been happening.
What you say about that last pass, that missed it. When you say drive the ball, you mean ripping.
You got to throw a fastball right under the chest of the wide receiver. And he's done that a couple of different times. Four to Michelli. Down inside the 10, he's trying to lob the ball, throw with touch, when he clearly needs to drive to throw that fastball right on the chest of his wide receiver. But on the other side of the ball, what can this quarterback do right now? Ryan Bowman's got to get his offense moving. The hard part is how has it really been given the keys to make a play down the field? You know, they've tried to play very cautious football, snapping the ball inside the 5 seconds of the play clock, not taking shots down the field, safe throws. And they're going to have to open that up a little bit if they're going to want to drive the length of the field and score a touchdown. Now, first down, they hand it off to Edwards. Rutgers was only 40 yards prior to that run in the second half. That's good. Edwards just gives them a different dimension. I mean, they just look different as an offense. When number 13 is in the background. Second and four. Edwards again. And first down. Edwards gets to the 4-yard line. And south. Excellent job by Gus Edwards there. And good job by this offensive line covered up. The linebackers at the second level, so we can make that cut and get to the second level and get the chance to move. That's why I'm saying Edwards. Driven out nicely by the base. But now it's weird to pick up some positive yardage in front of Vita Vea. And it's a 4-yard gain. The way that you can mix in now a play call is use the ability to run the football to your advantage. Keep Gus Edwards in the game, which looks like he's going to come off and get a breather. But then this is where you play action pass to get your quarterback outside of the pocket and try to change what's called the launch point for the quarterback and get him outside where he can read the wide receivers down the field.
Edwards, 19 carries, 60 yards, second half and 6. From the 42,
good showing blitz. On the back up. Good job. Brown. In the block. Trying to throw high. Brought down by Martin, but he won't get back to the line of scrimmage. And he'll actually lose a yard on the play. As Miles Bryant comes up with the open mute attack.
I've been really impressed
with Miles Bryant in the fight for Washington tonight. He's just a sophomore, 5'8", 180 pounds. But he's been playing that nifty position that we saw Buda Baker play a year ago. Buda was undersized, and obviously he was a tremendous asset and effect of the game. But Bryant has done a great job tonight. He's the corner. Top of your screen in the slot. 39, 7, and 41. Buda Baker, second round pick. Well, there have been some objectives met for Washington in finding young players in the secondary that are ready for this stage and ready to be great players. I feel like has been achieved. Miles Bryant has played great, using up in coverage, up man coverage, where Bolton was trying to throw the ball and then playing almost a pseudo safety position. Byron Murphy with his second interception tonight. But Daniel, fellow the redshirt freshman, picking off Kyle Bolton. FBS and takeaways with 33 last season. First and 10. Out all sorts of pressure. This has to put that one out of his hands. Sebastian Joseph, Kevin Williams, getting into the backfield. He was really lucky. Edmund Blatcher was even in the vicinity of that, really, the shovel pass. I mean, Neil Devers just a desperate attempt to get the ball out of his hands. Chiefman Plager is in the area, number six. Browning moves to snap on second and 10. Second and 10 to the 39. Closing moments of the third quarter. Browning circles. Drops it off. Gaskin makes the first man miss. Looks like he comes down. Drives all the way inside the Rutgers 20 for a 21-yard gain. When the play has been sluggish, sometimes you need playmakers to just go out there and make plays. Dominique Pettis did it in the first half in a punt return, and Miles Gaskin thus has done that so far here in the second half. What a great catch and run from number 9. Coming up, good stuff. The fourth quarter, and the Stars, the Washington Huskies, are finally starting to play. Back after this.
$250 total cash allowance on 2017 Dodge Charger models. Carbs to refuel. Electrolytes to help replenish what you lose in sweat. Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, and refuel.
The future of Washington's prosperity depends on education. And when we support students, we support our state. That's why the University of Washington creates access to opportunity through mentorship initiatives, and the Dream Project, scholarships, and programs like the Husky Promise and Program. Investing in people and their potential. Because what you care about can change the world.
Sample got loose for a nice game, and then the defense
Washington with the catch and the first down. For Monday,
the chains and keeps this drive alive for Rutgers. First down and 10 to 46. As an offensive coordinator, I've got to be very pleased, because those questions are that this is a much improved team than what we saw a year ago. Drastic improvement in the top. Second and one. Edwards. And he picks up the first down. Particularly this guy. He's a bruiser. That's Edwards. Edwards putting up some very good numbers. 21 carries, 72 yards. He's averaging 3.4 yards per carry with a long of 13 yards. He's got that perfect combination of vision and elusiveness in tight spaces, and yet he does have that thunder of being a physical back as well. And he's running right this time. And I thought Coach Kill was interesting when we talked to him yesterday. He said, you know what? My offensive line is experienced, so Gus is going to have to make the bet. Coaches will say, particular offensive coordinators or running backs coaches, they'll say it's going to be a BYOB day for the running back. I know everyone thinks they know what that means, but I'll tell you, it means be your own Gus. And sometimes that's what a running back has to do, and that's what Gus has done at times here tonight. Gus has always made people great. This time it's Robin Barton. I wish I was videotaping on my cell phone when you sat down with Gus yesterday, because you said, Gus, what's going on? He said, and I'm an Augustus in your eyes. Like, pizza saucers. You were so excited. Me too! He says, you know, you have a 7-month-old son. His name's Gus. Augustus Junior. We'll be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Not first down. 11:04 to count. Brings up 4-3. It looks like the Scarlet Knights will go for it.
Yeah, if there's any chance whatsoever, you're going to have to go for it. So, you're going to keep the offense on the field. And it's going to be Kyle Bowler trying to play. Every time that they really need a play, in particular in the pass game, they've done good job to Jerome Washington, the tight end.
Fourth down and three. Bowler looking in the end zone. And throwing the field. Oh,
by Bailey, goes upstairs, moves it down, still a ball game here at the scout.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, Sam, that stuff gets everywhere.
So the pool, the jacuzzi.
Yeah, an octagon for fighting.
Yeah, knock down.
If you can get figuring in your pro weekend, why don't you figure in your TV?
Introducing a la carte TV, only from Sam. Starting $20 a month, then get your personal channel and save.
Hey, come over here.
Keep looking at SlateTV.com and start watching 7 days free.
Burn your turn. Lock on that. City team, you break team. What's happening?
We'll go back to that touchdown, though. I thought it should have been reviewed. Let's go to the Hot Rules expert, Dean Blandino, back in Los Angeles. Dean, did you also feel like that play should have been reviewed?
I did, yeah. I'm looking at it here, and then the right knee's down. It looked like the ball was short. It was a really good look at it. Again, this is a game that's still close, but I understand that this was a game with a wider spread in the score because there was no competitive effect. And in a close game like this, right in the down, ball short of the goal line, shooting the side.
And I know there wasn't a clear view of the ball. However, with the whole right arm being clearly short of the goal line and presuming that the ball is in that right arm, that should have been plenty of evidence to stop that play and give it a further look.
Absolutely. You can see daylight between the body and the goal.
Dean, thank you so much. And happy to have Dean now, part of the family here at Fox Sports, part of our deep pool of rules analysts, which are the best in all of football. First down at 10 to 12 for Washington. They brought it. Both three progressions. And go to the ball. And it's caught by Samuel again. Washington caught the ball. 31 yards, now 23. As Isaiah Ward brings it down, I love this round. This halfway spot on the line. This must just be a flat route. But Browning breaks the pocket. He goes down the field. And he breaks the ball. That's Joseph with the tackle. The run game hasn't been there.
No.
Under 4 yards of carry so far.
They are ready to get
over carry on the night. And that was a staple for them a year ago. And as you know, this season, and they just are now able to establish themselves on the line of scrimmage. How proud of that offensive line.
So they've got.
Communication between quarterbacks.
Browning again was asking for a flag. And you see, he just stumbled. I mean, he wasn't even contacted there. That was 58 from Moko Turpe from his outside linebacker spot. Browning thought that there should be something there, maybe looking for a little laundry on the ground, but his wide receiver, Aaron Fuller, just stumbled. Tristan Vizcaino, end of the tip. A 42-yard. He's been good for 24, 23 yards today. Beautiful drop and good. Look at your golf shot right there, Joe Platt. Perfect. Vizcaino nails it. Washington adding to their total. Now my golf shot, which is perfect.
The 2017 Mitsubishi Outlander is standard third-row seat, one of America's safest crossovers, well equipped for under $24,000. Get up to $2,000 cash back or 0% APR for 72 months on select models.
Where the heart beats warm and true. That's Texas. Where we always love you. That's Texas. Where we always find a way. That's Texas.
Introducing Cotton Water.
you can score free pizza with every dollar you spend online and get unlimited double rewards through October 1st. Don't stop for a pizza surprise. Join Hut Rewards today and earn free pizza faster. That's why I'm talking about pizza
this Labor Day weekend.
Washington on top of Rutgers late in the fourth quarter. Let's go back and take a look at your original keys to the game.
Well, you know, as I said, that Washington had to find young secondary players. They've done a great job from 33 passing yards, allowed two interceptions, and Rutgers needed effort in key play. They've gotten effort for the most part, but they've turned the ball over a couple of times and allowed that punt return for a touchdown. So, you know, why clean that up? But overall, I think tonight you'd have to say very positive grade for the Rutgers. Rutgers started nice after last year's 2-10 season.
First down to 10, number 39. Bowman. And it's called by Washington. We look at the Pac-12. Huskers did finish first in the North in front of Stanford. USC picked to finish first in the South in front of Utah with 52 media members picking SC to win the championship. Second and two at the 47. Well, in the game. Back-to-back draft.
Looking forward for these teams, I feel like there's a lot to work on for Washington. And I know that they've got some talented players. The umpire here, he got sandwiched in between the players and kind of looked down. But he's backed up and comes. Tough this one out. It's one of the toughest jobs in all the sports right there.
First down, 49. Sniffing it out nicely. Tempest Buckley coming up with the tackle.
Washington, they're going to have a great shot. And not only win their division, but potentially win the Pac-12. For Rutgers, yeah, if we're all being honest, this probably wasn't a game you want to measure yourself against in this building transition, if you will, if you're Chris Ash.
Well, drops it off. Mark.
Beautiful goal.
And that goal gets the 41 in North Middle of the top.
So you start to ask yourself, are you seeing signs that you can up down the middle of the pack in the Big Ten Conference? Illinois, Minnesota, Indiana, Iowa, the world, which by the way, all four of those teams, Rutgers had a chance to beat in the fourth quarter a year ago. Yes, absolutely. We've seen evidence that they're going to be not only more competitive, but vastly more competitive in those games. We have a shot to potentially go to a bowl game this year.
But I got a big fourth down for Rutgers. 53 to play. They're down 30 to 14.
Quiet confidence and the push of a button.
$480. Electricity without the shopping. Cabela's Outdoorsman will start gently. Great price. Every day. Only at Cabela's.
Cards to refuel. Electrolytes to help replenish what you lose in sweat. Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, and refuel.
The famously clippable, often imitated, never duplicated Dairy Queen Blizzard. There's absolutely nothing like it. Unless, there's two. Right now, buy your favorite Blizzard and get another for just 99 cents. That's buy one, get one for 99 cents.
This is Jeff, applying for a job and getting it. This is Jeff's new boss, Susan, closing a big deal and expensive lunch. This is Sean, a waiter, a husband, now a father. This is Helen, clocking out at the end of a really rewarding day. And this is Jeff again, making his wife's day even better. This is Paycom, doing more for your workforce. Art. This is beautiful detail, a painting of luxury stripes.
It's a moment I'll never forget.
I was dumped for again in the hospital.
I hope he's morbidly disfigured in a horrific jet skiing accident.
30-14, Washington, ranked 8th in the nation. Leading record 6-2 for the Scott Knights here. Giving a half-court kick for the first down. Ben Burke-Herman coming up with the tackle. And the Scarlet Knights turn it over on downs.
Ben Burke-Herman started in place of the suspended Azeem Victor. Victor, one of the only returning all Pac-12 players in the entire conference on the defensive side. But Burke-Herman has played well tonight. 44 tackles a year ago. And he is a good effort player. Always in the right spot. And he was in the right spot on that fourth down. As Washington will go with their backups now, get rounding out of the back, that hot game. A.J. Carter Samuels, the junior from Saratoga, California, in a quarterback. That's Colby. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Carter Samuels, he was Chris Peterson's first quarterback who was Washington. Played most of the second half against Rutgers last year, completing both of his passes. 9-13, 104, 3 touchdowns, no picks a season ago. He's back. Rounding tonight, 17-30. 24, a couple of touchdowns. They're going to have some things to clean up, in particular the pressure that he was under early. Now that offensive line is going to have to do a much better job of keeping him clean so that he can get the ball down the field. Second down and 9. And let's quickly check in with Rob Stone.
Hey guys, after this one, it's like college football. That's before we're going to talk college football. You know what the highlights are going to have? Clatter, the Buffaloes. The rivalry game, this is Colorado State. Wisconsin, slow start. They finally got it going on. Tom Williams gave me the Texas guys.
Yes, they did.
Imagine that.
You gave me a look today and you said, you were going to go
back. 7.
Yeah,
hold
it.
They were a quarterback at Colorado. They looked bad. I think that was back of last year.
Yeah, you remember he started at Oregon last year when they went up there and beat the Ducks and kind of put themselves on the map in that game. Stephen Montez, officer, up right now on Colorado State. Really good rivalry game there in Denver, playing a mile high. Montez, 21-29, over 200 yards, throw a touchdown, throw a couple of picks, but the defense for the Buffs playing well again. Remember how good their defense was a year ago?
This is all very good.
Last year in the Pac-12 championship.
championship game, and they'll go back to Boulder September 23rd. There's the next five for Washington, Montana, and Fresno State at home, and then at Colorado, at Oregon.